The Road to Oz by L. Frank Baum. Chapter 1. The Way to Butterfield.
"Please, miss," said the Shaggy Man, "can you tell me the road to Butterfield?" Dorothy looked him over. Yes, he was shaggy all right, but there was a twinkle in his eye that seemed pleasant. "Oh, yes," she replied, "I can tell you, but it isn't this road at all."
"No?"
"You cross the 10-acre lot, follow the lane to the highway, go north to the 5 branches, and take, let me see..."
"To be sure, miss. See as far as Butterfield, if you like," said the Shaggy Man.
"You take the branch next to the willow stump, I believe, or else the branch by the gopher holes, or else..."
"Won't any of 'em do, miss?"
"Course not, Shaggy Man. You must take the right road to get to Butterfield. And is that the one by the gopher stump, or..."
"Dear me," cried Dorothy, "I shall have to show you the way. You're so stupid. Wait a minute till I run in the house and get my sunbonnet."
The Shaggy Man waited. He had an oat straw in his mouth, which he chewed slowly as if it tasted good, but it didn't. There was an apple tree beside the house, and some apples had fallen to the ground. The Shaggy Man thought they would taste better than the oat straw, so he walked over to get some. A little black dog with bright brown eyes dashed out of the farmhouse and ran madly toward the Shaggy Man, who had already picked up 3 apples and put them in one of the big, wide pockets of his shaggy coat. The little dog barked and made a dive for the Shaggy Man's leg, but he grabbed the dog by the neck and put it in his big pocket along with the apples. He took more apples afterward, for many were on the ground, and each one that he tossed into his pocket hit the little dog somewhere upon the head or back and made him growl. The little dog's name was Toto, and he was sorry he had been put in the Shaggy Man's pocket.